All right, welcome Daiwa fans. Mark Mills here. Welcome to the 2020-21 Daiwa New Product Showcase. My name is Mark Mills. I'm the field marketing manager for Daiwa. We're getting this opportunity to kind of go through all the new products here for our 2021 season. With that being said, if you guys have any questions or comments or anything like that, you can slide onto our YouTube channel. It's Daiwa USA's YouTube channel. For any questions, comments, we're going to be taking those. We're going to start off and go through everything here. Just so you guys know, we are practicing social distancing. So I'm going to slide in and out of the camera here. I'm going to introduce Alex right now, who's going to go through the first set of products. But thank you very much. We're welcome to have you guys.
How's it going, guys? Alex Planbeck here, West Coast and Southwest Regional Sales Manager. Here today to talk to you guys about the new Saltiga lever drag. So we're introducing a new Saltiga lever drag this year. This is a completely redesigned reel from the previous model. So this will be available in both a single speed and a two speed. I'm showing off the two speed here. This is the 60 size. So the single speed will be available in a 10 through 60 size. We'll have a couple larger sizes in the 50 and 60 size designed for the sailfish market. Those are tournament sailfish reels. A little less drag on those reels, 22 pounds of drag. And then on the two-speed reels, the one you see here, we're going to offer this in a 15 size all the way up to a 60 size. The larger 50, 55, and 60 sizes will come with the salt and pepper shaker style handle here. Really nice handle. Fits really nice in your hand. It's not going to wear down your hands, but you're going to get a ton of power out of this handle. This reel has all CRBBs. It has six CRBBs in it. It also has our ATD drag system in it. With that ATD drag, you're getting up to 45 pounds of drag out of this reel. So perfect for any big game species that you're gonna encounter. Also, something we wanted to note is it does have stainless steel gears. Both the main and pinion gear are stainless steel, very hard gear, very large gear. So you get a ton of torque out of this reel, but it is also very quiet and very smooth for having those stainless steel gears in it. This is gonna retail anywhere from $419 to $699, depending on your price point. It also does come with a 5-year Saltiga executive warranty. You can check out more information on our website.
Nice job, Alex. Yeah, those lever drags are going to be awesome. We already know that. We've done a lot of testing, 2 years plus in testing on them. And it's like I said, it's a redesign. So if you're not a lever drag guy and you want to get into the saltwater world and you want a spinning reel, we're going to introduce here and I'm going to talk about the new Daiwa BG. This is actually the Daiwa BG MQ, and what makes it special is, I'll grab the front one here, is our true MQ design. So what MQ stands for is monocoque design. This is a all one piece aluminum frame. It's not painted, it's anodized. But what makes this MQ technology very special for us is that there is no screw hole. So you don't have to worry about any type of screw holes where you're going to get an inaccurate movement in the reel. So if you're pulling on a fish, lots of power and lots of torque, this one piece frame and this one piece side plate gives 365 degrees of stability. And that allows us to use a bigger gear for more power and more torque at the same gear ratio. What it also does too, it keeps water out of the reel more and allows for a lot less torque, which will slow you down and bind. So when you're pulling on big fish, it works really well. Also in this reel here, this reel comes in a 2500 all the way to a 20,000. So it's a big line of reels, 2500, 3000, all the way to a 20,000 size reel. Getting back more into the features portion of this too, it has our ATD, which is our advanced tournament drag system. So it's a very smooth, very accurate drag. It's high drag pressure as well. And then we've also added in this reel, I'm gonna set this down and pick this up. So I'm gonna try and push this up nice and tight to you here. So on this BG, which stands for big game, is that we have 9 rubber seals. So you're gonna see here up tight, we got a rubber seal here to protect the drag washers and the drag surfaces. We've got 4 rubber seals right here to protect the one-way roller bearing, which is a vital portion in a spinning reel. And it also will protect any water getting into the gear set. So as we're looking here on the MQ as well, you also have a seal that goes around this portion of the side plate. And this portion here, bottom of the side. So you got 2 seals there that protect this reel as well. You also have another seal on here to protect any water getting into the one-way roller bearing or any water on this side getting here. So it's very well protected. It's great if you're a guide or any type of saltwater application where you're getting a lot of moisture, a lot of water. It's on the water a lot for a lot of trips in a row. Great reel. This is going to come in from $199 to $279, depending on the price points. And it's pretty much going to arrive in about late August on that. So great reel thing. This is a new Daiwa BG Big Game MQ monocoque design. So Daiwa Big Game MQ.
Alrighty, guys. Next new reel we're going to cover is the new Procyon AL. If you see here, we have it displayed here. Very nice looking reel. This is going to retail for $179.99. It's available in a 2000 size all the way up to a 4000 size. We have our Procyon LT in the current lineup. This is going to be an aluminum body version of that reel. This reel is perfect for both the freshwater but also the saltwater angler. You can fish both fresh and saltwater with this. It has our air bale, which is this nice hollow thick bale wire, which is easy to use. Very lightweight for an aluminum body reel. Also very sharp looking. You see that high-end silver look to it. All around, just a great reel for both the freshwater and saltwater angler, coming in at $179.99.
All right, nice job, Alex. Getting back into the spinning reels, I'm going to take it to the next step. This is the new Kage MQ. As I was just talking about in the saltwater reels, the MQ design is a very, very big feature for us. You saw it when we introduced the big new Saltigas this year. You've seen it with Exist and Certate. If you are a Daiwa fan and you're familiar with our products. So we've added this same technology, the MQ technology, like I said in the last reel on the BG that we're talking about, is that it's an all one-piece frame, allows for a lot less torque, for more pressure, bigger gears, everything like that, better water resistant. But what we've done here with the Kage is that actually instead of using aluminum, we've used our Daiwa Zion body. So it's all one-piece Zion. What Zion is actually a true carbon reel. It's our Daiwa's proprietary carbon, much stiffer than most of the carbons on the market. So you're not going to get very much frame flex. But what that also does, especially in the MQ body, is it allows the gears and the bearings to stay in precise alignment. That's going to make your reel fish better, last longer, be smoother, all around great. This reel here also is mag sealed, so it has our mag seal technology that you've been able to hear, which is kind of an oil bubble that doesn't allow any type of water to travel into the one-way roller bearing, protecting the gear set as well. This reel here, actually, it's very lightweight. It actually comes in a 1,000 to a 4,000 size, so you get your 1,000s, your 2,000s, 2,500, 3, and 4,000s. The smaller 1000s and 2000s are going to have a small cork handle. The 2500, 3000, and 4000 is going to have a rubber handle, a little bit more durability, a little bit bigger handle to grab onto. Price point for this reel is $339 to $369. Now, you aren't going to be able to buy Kage online. It's a dealer-only item, so go to your local dealer and find that to pick up one of these Kage reels. And you're also going to see this reel show up in pretty much late October. But great reel, air rotor, air bale. It's got a Zion rotor, Zion frame, and MQ. This is the new Kage MQ black with a little bit of red. It's a hot looking reel and it's gonna do really well. One more, sorry, my bad. Forgot, I get to do another one. Sorry guys, almost forgot. Last but not least, we're gonna talk about the new Tatula 300. Expanded low profile reel. So we've been real successful the last few years with the Lexa designs and everything, but they've had a standard level wine. This reel here, the new Tatula 300, actually what makes this reel great, it's actually got the T-Wing TWS design. This is huge. So the reason that it's a big benefit on the Tatula 300 here is that when you get into a reel that's this wide, the width really takes the line and makes it go back and forth a lot. Using this T-Wing is going to allow you a much further cast, much better distance, a lot less backlashing, and all around a real great reel for making casts. It's actually the only reel in the market in this size that has this type of feel feature to really help you cast. So what we're going to be using this reel here, the new 300, is for pulling baits. Big crankbaits, DD22s, 10XDs, 8XDs, any of you big freshwater guys, it's going to work great for that. Throwing A-rigs, big swim baits. This matches up real good with some of the new Tatula rods we'll be talking about tomorrow. But all in all, it's a great reel for pulling baits. Comes in three different gear ratios. You're going to be able to find it in a 6.3, 7-1, and 8-1. Like I said, we've got a large T-Wing on here. And with the T-Wing, we've added a little bit bigger hole here. So if you're using heavier lines to get that knot through, that'll help it out as well. MSRP on this reel is going to run about $269. We've added a new type of handle. If you can take a look at this handle, it's got 110 millimeter throw. So it's a big throw for lots of power and lots of torque, and big rubber knobs that allows you to get on that to turn that handle. So this will be arriving in late August. These are kind of all the new products that we're talking about today. Today is our reel day, so we're only talking about reel products. The next couple days, we'll be going live with other things. But we've got lots of questions and stuff. So with that being said, if, like I said at the beginning of this, if you have questions, comments, or anything like that, go to our Daiwa USA YouTube page. We're going to start answering some questions right now. But all around, great reel for pulling baits. Comes in left and right-handed. And we're going to start with some questions. I'm going to bring Alex in here to answer the next question for us, or the first question.
Alrighty. First question is from Brian. He's wondering about the BGMQ. He's wondering about the MagSeal technology. The reel does not have MagSeal technology. Mark went over earlier. It does have 9 rubber seals that protect the reel. So in order to hit that price point, $200 reel with 9 rubber seals and that MQ technology, that's going to keep most of the water out of your gears and also your bearings. So a very water resistant reel for that price point. BGMQ is a great reel. We've been out fishing it here on the West Coast for tuna, yellowfin, and the bluefin that we have off our coast right now. We also launched some lures on our website. If you guys have any questions, again, check out our YouTube page. And we also have our website with all of our new products. So we launched over 30 new products. Today we're going over the reels, and then we'll have some other live videos for you guys on the rods, the line, the lures, accessories that we want to cover. So I'll hand it off to Mark here. He's going to take another question, but that's the BGMQ.
All right, cool. All right, we got a question here. Let's see here. What makes the, okay, what the BGMQ uses the same size as Saltigo? What's the question there? I say he uses the same size as a, oh, as far as the sizing. Yes, actually, we've actually changed up our sizing a little bit. So you guys are very familiar, as we introduced in January, the Saltigo reel. And we changed our sizing up a little bit on that reel. We've also done the same type of sizing here, kind of getting more of standardization in the industry to a true 20,000 size. So we have our 20,000s, 18,000s, 14,000s, 10,000s, 8,000s, 6,000s, 5,000s. All the way down in sizes, but our sizing did change. This is our largest 20,000, so you guys are familiar how big it is. The line capacities on it, it's big reel, great for fishing, big poppers, anything of that nature. I'll show you the next size here. We don't have every single sample, but this here is an 8,000, which is kind of the sweet spot for a lot of people here on the West Coast. Also, a lot of people on the East Coast, the 6 and 8,000 are really kind of the sweet spots. So you can see kind of the size difference right here. So 20,000, 8,000, and then I will also, sorry guys, show you the cutout here. This cutout is a 6,000, so you can kind of see the difference between the 6,000 and the 8,000. But we did change our sizing up. You're going to see us eventually kind of change our whole spinning sizing to a different than what we've done in the past. It can't happen immediately, but it's going in stages. As you saw, we did with the Saltigo reels. Now we're doing it with the BGMQs.
Alrighty, the next question is about the Tatula 300. They're wondering if the T-Wing system is larger on this Tatula 300. The answer is yes. We've added a larger T-Wing system to the Tatula 300 to allow for larger knots to pass through the guide. So you see the T-Wing system here is a larger T-Wing than our 100 and 200 size reels. So if you're casting knots through this, you're gonna be able to cast a little bit larger diameter knots through this. We still recommend using a short leader that possibly doesn't go through the level wind here, or just tying a nice compact knot that'll fit through that T-wing easily. But the T-wing is larger on this reel than the current 100 and 200 size reels that we currently offer. All around, just a great reel. A lot of guys are going to be using this for throwing A-rigs, big swim baits. It does have 2 CRBBs in the reel as well, so it's going to be very durable. You can throw this in harsh environments. It's going to hold up well over time.
Thanks, Alex. Yeah, that thing also, you can also use it in salt water as well, so they can use it for that. All right, what makes a sailfish model different than the regular Saltigo lever drags? Okay, that's a big one. So we have 2 what we call our tournament sailfish models in the lineup. This here is the 50 size. We also do one in the 60 size. So these two are going to be in the lineup. Now, this one is a regular two-speed. So what makes a Sailfish model special is, number one, it's got a special cam in it. Due to the Sailfish regulations and light line monofilaments, guys are using 20-pound, they're using 30-pound monofilament. You need a lot of line, so that's why it's a little bit bigger. But you also need it really fast. One, a Sailfish is fast, you've got to take up line. Two is, once your line pops out of the kit, the kit of the kite, it actually comes down, and when that pops out, you can take up that really fast. This one actually goes really quick here. You're looking at about 56 inches per crank on this reel right here, which is a ton of speed on it. You're also going to notice on the Sailfish reels is that we don't use the big metal handle because we're looking for speed. So you go ahead and grab the rubber handle, makes it easy. You can go through this really fast with a lot of speed. On the two speeds, this big handle is too big. It's just too much torque. You can't go as fast. So all in all, different drag curve, different handle, and a lot more speed for this reel to be able to fish better.
Alrighty, questions are starting to come in. We got another question. What is the main benefit of the MQ frames? As you guys see, a lot of our frames are going to that MQ technology. We have the Exist, the Certate, now we're bringing it into the saltwater market in the BGMQ. The main benefit of that MQ technology is you have a one-piece plate that screws in here, almost like the gas cap on your car. What that does is it creates 360 degrees of stability right here, so you don't have any screw holes in the side plate here. So that allows us to seal the reel a lot better as well, so you're not going to get water in through those screw holes. You're not going to have any weak points where those screw holes would be, and then allows us to put a lot larger gear in the reel. So this BGMQ has a considerably larger gear than a lot of the traditional reels on the market. All in all, this is just a super solid, durable reel. Very compact, very strong, tons of drag. You guys are going to be really happy with this reel. We also have another question coming in. What spinning reel works well for shark fishing? I'd probably go with this one, the bigger BGMQ. This is the 20,000 size, so either this one or the 18,000 size. Any sort of shore fishing where you're long casting with heavy weights, you're going to want a little bit larger reel. It's going to hold more line. One thing that's cool about this BGMQ is it actually comes with a J-braid ready spool. So there is a nice little rubber ring on the spool, so you don't have to tape it before you fill it up with braided line. Nice little feature that we added on the BGMQ. But for shark fishing, I like the larger sizes, the 18 and the 20,000. You're going to get plenty of line on there, whether you're fishing braid as a backing or straight braid. I'd recommend putting some braid on there, but yeah, 20,000 or 18,000 is the go-to size.
Awesome. All right. Got another question coming in here. Quite a few more. When are the Tutula 300s coming out? We're going to be seeing those pretty quick here. I believe those will be showing up here in pretty much late August. So just a few months away. It's going to be great. For guys throwing A rigs, like we said, pulling baits. So late August is when the Tutula 300 is going to be coming out for all that stuff. So just a few more months away, guys.
Alrighty, next is can you show frame size difference between the Kage and Procyon? Is MQ body smaller? Yeah, the MQ body is going to be smaller. Like I mentioned, you get a more compact reel. You also get a lighter reel with a larger gear in it. So the Procyon AL, remember, is going to be a lightweight aluminum versus the Kage MQ is going to be a Zion-based reel, so it's going to be even lighter. This one's also mag-sealed, so the Procyon is not mag-sealed, this one is mag-sealed. So as you go up in price, the reels get lighter. We also add in that mag-sealed technology and that MQ technology that we talked about. So you can see that MQ technology here on the side plate.
Okay, BGMQ price point. So this actually price point on the BGMQs are going to run from about $199 to $279. So the smallest at the 2500 size, $199, up to the larger size right here of $279. So it's at a really good price, just under $300, and it'll work out really well. And just to let you guys know, we're not getting rid of the other BG. It's just at a different price point. And you have the new key features, which is the MQ design. So we're going to keep our regular BG big game. And we've just added here the BGMQ to our Daiwa lineup. As you see, we are really expanding our saltwater market. We're looking at it much more strongly now. So you're going to see a lot of cool stuff this year, obviously, and in the future from Daiwa in the saltwater world.
Alrighty, we got another question coming in. Someone wants to know the benefit to our Zion technology. So Zion is going to be the lightest, strongest material that we offer. It's going to be lighter than any carbon-based reel that we offer, but also stronger than any carbon-based reel on the market. So very rigid, you don't get any flex in the Zion, but it remains super lightweight. So compared to an aluminum reel, it's going to be lighter and also very rigid. We're offering that on the Kage MQ. Second you pick up this reel, you'll notice how light it is. We have our Zion technology, we have our air bale, and then also the air rotor. So all that technology that we have combined in this reel makes the reel super lightweight.
All right, we got another question here. How much drag does a Saltiga 60 have? Okay, guys, well, I'll start off by talking about the two-speed 60 versus the single-speed Sailfish 60. The two-speed 60, at full strike with full speed free spool, you're looking at exactly about 45 pounds of drag, which is a ton of drag pressure. I'm going to kind of lock this up. As you can hear, this reel's got a good ramp, a ton of drag pressure, easy to turn the handle, enough to catch any of our, especially out here, 200, 300 pound tuna out here. We've been doing real well. We've actually had fish on this reel to 209. I think they had like a 219 or 319 a couple days ago. So you're looking at 45 pounds of drag. Now there is a difference, and I said this before, between the 60 Sailfish reel and the 62 speed. The 60 Sailfish reel, which is a single speed, only gets a max of 22 pounds of drag. And that's so you can fill a lot of line up, a lot of light monofilament. You don't need that high drag curve for that. You're going to use it for, popping out of kites, picking up slack. If a fish goes one way and another fish goes another way, you need the line capacities. But on that type of fishing, you're fishing light line. You're fishing 20 pound, 30 pound monofilament. So Sailfish reels, much different than the actual two speed reel. So, the Sailfish reels, like I said, light line, light drag curve. This one, much steeper drag curve, a lot more power, a lot more torque. And you need those heavier drag pressures. Okay, I'm going to slide back in, Alex.
Alrighty, next question. Can you fish braid on the Procyon AL? Yeah, of course. You can fish both braid or mono on there. I'd recommend fishing some J-braid on there. We offer it in the 4 for the saltwater, the 8, in both our 8 carrier and our grand. So depending on your application, whether you're going to be fishing freshwater or saltwater, I'd recommend probably putting the J-braid grand. It performs really nicely on the spinning reels. It's a nice soft braid, does really well. So on this, anywhere from like 20 to 30 pound braid would do well on these reels. Depends on your fishing application, if you're going to be fishing freshwater bass or fishing inshore for redfish, snook, anything like that. But definitely recommend putting some braid on here.
All right, question is, what size Saltiga for the West Coast tuna? Now, that's an interesting scenario. We've actually, in the last 7 years, evolved out here on the West Coast. And people, guys, have been using the bigger reels. The 60 size on that size seems to be the average purchase by everyone. And I've seen this year that the reels tend to be getting a little bit smaller. I think that we're learning how to catch these fish better. The lines are better. Now on the two speeds, we make three different two speeds really designed for that type of fishing with this bigger handle. So we have here, which is the 60 size. This is kind of the average by most guys. You can put 100 pound on it. It'll hold close to 550 yards, 100 pound, somewhere around there. It's like 660 yards of 80 pound. But what we're seeing is the guys going a little bit smaller. I think they realize that they can still catch all these big fish on smaller gear. We did this years ago with everything else that we've done. So the 55 is actually the same diameter of this. It's just a little bit narrower. That's kind of been the sweet spot. I see a lot of dealers purchasing that right now. It's kind of the sweet spot. But not to mention, we do make it in a 50 size as well, which is this size. But we've added in that 50 size this big handle. And I think that that's kind of the next generation. One of our pro staff has been catching quite a few fish in the 200 pound class that's been testing with the 50 size and this. So Ideally, if you're looking for one reel to purchase of the two speeds for West Coast big tuna, bluefin tuna fishing, the 60's the perfect spot. I see guys going to the 55, and I think the new era, the guys are even going to go smaller, especially on the private boats, to the 50 size with that big handle.
Alrighty, next question is, what is the main difference between the current BG and the BGMQ? So we are keeping the current BG in line, adding to it with the BGMQ. So the main differences between the new one and the previous model that's staying in line, this reel has 9 rubber seals in it, so it's going to be a little bit more water resistant. It also has our MQ technology, which we've talked about a lot. This one piece screw and side plate here, that allows us to put a lot larger gear in the reel, seal the reel a lot better, and you're also going to get more strength out of this reel. So those are kind of the main differences between this and the current or the previous model. Obviously price is a little bit higher, but you're getting that MQ technology, the water resistance of this reel, and the performance.
All right, we got another question here that came in on the BGMQs. This is a big reel for us throughout now both seas, but the East Coast, the West Coast, the Southwest, the Northeast. All these guys are going to love these reels. So the question that we have is the BGMQ material, gear material, what's it made out of? It is actually made out of zinc. So we are using a zinc gear, similar to the same material that we are currently using on our Saltus reels and our BGs now, but we're using the material that's about 25 to 30% larger. So bigger teeth, bigger tooth pattern. And what we've done is we've done testing a lot with the competition's reels out there. And this zinc gear is actually more durable due to its size and its tooth pattern than a lot of the other gears in the market by the competition's using. But it is a zinc gear. It is a digi gear, so it's digitally cut, digitally polished. That's what's going to give it the really excellent smooth feel. I mean, you can almost, as you can see, how smooth that reel is. But it'll also hold up very, very well. So it is a zinc gear, but 20 to 35% larger than our current BGs in the market. And then even though so on the competition as well, just bigger, more power, more torque. Go ahead.
Alrighty guys, we got one more question here about the Tutula 300, fishing mono or braid on the Tutula 300. Like we mentioned before, it is equipped with the T-wing system. A lot of guys are throwing 20-pound fluorocarbon on this reel. You're going to get plenty of line with this larger 300-size reel. So I'd recommend using some of our new J-Fluoro Samurai on this reel. Very high-quality Japanese fluorocarbon will perform very well on this reel.
Okay, great question. Why is ATD drag good in the new Saltiga lever drags? So we have two different types of drag materials. We have the UTD and the ATD. So the ATD, Advanced Tournament Drag, does a couple different things. One, it's got a very smooth drag curve for beginning to end. So it's got a very smooth curve. It also does very well at high heat pressures. So especially like on the two speeds with lots of drag pressure and a fish 300 pounds running, you know, 200, 300 yards off of your reel, you need a smooth drag. You need it to hold up to the heat, and it holds up really well. The difference between the ATD and the UTD is the UTD drag system has a very, very steep curve. It starts really hard for, it's mainly for bass fishing, but it starts hard and then it slows and goes real smooth. Not a very good type of drag material for the saltwater market. It's mainly designed for quick hook sets and then smoothness. On the saltwater side, for heat dissipation, for durability, and for everything else, the ATD, that's why we put that material in our Saltiga reels and actually quite a few of our saltwater reels. Any more questions, guys? Kind of nailed it. All right, well, we want to thank you very much. We'll kind of both get into the screen here a little bit and say thanks very much for going through all the 2020-21 products. Alex, do you have anything to say here to the team?
Thank you guys for watching. If you guys have any questions about the new products, please check out our website. New product showcase. We have all new products. Today we obviously went over the reels. Tomorrow we'll be going over the rods. And then the next day we'll be going over the reels, or sorry, the line, lures, and accessories.
Yep. So make sure you guys check back with us. Thank you for all your great questions. We had a fun time doing this. It does make it tough having to go back and forth, but we are practicing our social distancing, and I hope you like the products. Go to your local Daiwa retailer to find out more about these things or check out our website.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.